back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video today. I really appreciate it. I want to just say a happy new year to all of you guys. I hope that you have a great 2018. So to kick off this new year, I decided to come to you guys with a Valentine's Day look. I know I'm early, but I'm excited, okay? But this is the look that I came up with, guys. I hope that you enjoy this look. It features some pink, some red. I hope that you enjoy this look and that you try this look out. Alright guys, let's begin by taking this baby pink color from the 88 palette. If you don't have the 88 palette, you can use a baby pink from any palette that you have at home. As long as the pink is matte, it should work fine. So just go ahead and grab your own palette and just follow me, okay? Just do what I do, alright? So the transition color helps the eyeshadow that we will put on following, or the eyeshadow following, to blend a little bit easier. And it also helps with that gradient, okay? We always talking about that gradient. It helps with that gradient. So now I'm gonna take this pencil, it's called Mahogany by Nabi, and I'm just gonna carve out a cut crease. And I'm making this line thick, not too thick, not too thin, because if it's too thin, it will be difficult to blend, alright? So we're taking this pencil brush, and I'm using this just to blend that color into my first transition color. I'm focusing on blending the top of that line versus the bottom because I want that line to stay as sharp at the bottom as possible. I'm just putting this down as a sort of a base for this color right here, which is a red color from the 88 palette. I know it want to look like deep pink to me on camera, but in person it is actually red, and on my eye in person it looks like a deep pink as well. But in the palette it looks red. I'm just using a shader brush to place this on wherever that second base went. Now I'm just using my Anastasia brush to blend that into my first transition color. Now I'm taking this shimmery gold color, it's called 18 Karat Gold from Coastal Scents again, and I'm just using that to highlight under my brow really quickly. This is the NYX Jumbo Pencil. I'm taking this and I'm using this on a flat brush. I'm doing a cut crease. Y'all, we ain't new to cut crease around here. We true to this, all right? So I'm using this just to carve out a cut crease as usual. And when you're doing this, you want to make sure that it is smooth and crisp. You want that line to be, you want that line to cut someone, you know what I'm saying? So now I'm taking this color, it's called Peach Fuzz. Then I'm taking this color, pray for my Anastasia palette. So yeah, I'm taking this color, it looks true to color on camera. In the palette it didn't look true to color. On the eyes it looks true to color right now. Sometimes my camera and all the light like blows out the color. It makes it look a lot faded or a lot different than what it actually looks like. But that color, that's showing true to color. Now I'm going back and I'm taking that red that we took initially and I'm using this fluffy brush. Mistake number one. That was a mistake, because guys, like, that made that eyeshadow, that made that base, like, curd. I don't know, it started to get bumpy. It was weird.
So I just went over with that red, and I'm still using that red to like deepen up the cut crease area, the top of it, to make that cut crease pop. And I used a flat brush to like finish up whatever, because like I said, that brush wasn't working out. This is what it looked like now. That's what it was looking like. Just sometimes you have to like really get different angles to see if everything's straight. So that's why I left that in there with me looking around. Now I'm just blending everything. I like to go over it and make sure everything is blended together. And once you blend, y'all, that's what makes the eyeshadow looks great. Like once that blending is intact, then you won't have nothing to worry about. So for my third part, the wing. Y'all, I wasn't going for Amy Winehouse wing, but I don't know, I just feel like I just can't help myself. Like I feel like I can't help myself. But on Valentine's Day, I would prefer having a small wing than this dramatic wing that I have now, but I couldn't help myself. Now I'm just taking that red color and I'm just lightly like making a halo around my wing and just, you know, detailing that red color, y'all. My next eye is finished and we're on to the lashes, baby. These lashes are called Girl About Town by Coco Lashes. I'll place where I got them from in the description, and boom, just like that, they're on. I like how it looks so far. It looks so good. Oh man. Okay, these are my ColourPop lipsticks. I wanted to show you guys them. So just in case you want to swatch, I just purchased all of them the other day. Now I'm taking this lip pencil. It's called Cocoa. Is that? No, that one is Chestnut. That's Chestnut. I'm taking Chestnut and I'm lining my lips. I initially wanted to do just Chestnut and then the lipstick that follows, but I don't like it. I don't like it on camera, so you'll see what I did. I'll leave the name for that lipstick in the description because I can't remember if that's Bare It All or just Peachy. I took a ColourPop lipstick, and I'll put this in the description as well, and I didn't show it. I cannot remember which one I use right now. Check my description for everything that you need. I promise I will update it. So I'm just using this to line my lips. And I'm doing my lips in and out so that it can blend together. So I took a lip pencil and I'm making sure that the edge of my lip on that side is sharp, because I have like a scar there, and it seems like these days that scar is getting more noticeable. Anyway, so I'm just making sure that everything is smooth and even.